Welcome to Hood War Stories. In this episode, I'll be discussing the Rollin' 40 Neighborhood Crips. The Rollin' 40 Crips, also known as Glove Gang, is a predominantly Black American gang located on the west side of South Central Los Angeles. They originated in the 1970s and are a part of the Rollin' 40 Crips. Their neighborhood stretches from Vernon Ave to 48th Street between Crenshaw and Figueroa. They are clicked up with the Harlem 30s and beef with BPS, Fruittown Brims, Inglewood Families, Van Ness Gangsta Bloods, and more recently, the Rollin' 60s, who used to be one of their main allies. On August 4th, 2013, members of the Rollin' 40s, 60s, 90s, and 100s were at a party on the 11100 block of Western Avenue, which is located in Rollin' 100 territory. Edwin, also known as EV from Rollin' 40s, got into a physical altercation with a Rollin' 60 member, allegedly over a female. Edwin proceeded to beat the Rollin' 60 member down, and that escalated into a brawl between the 40s and the 60s. The Rollin' 60 member who got beat down came back into the party with a gun and started firing. Edwin was struck multiple times and died from his gunshot wounds. Another member of the 40s was hit as well, but he survived. 2 days later on August 6, 2013, at around 10:45 p.m., Mitchell was walking on the sidewalk on the 6200 block of Madden Avenue, which is located in Rollin' 60 territory. Two males then walked up and one of them began firing at Mitchell. He was hit two times and died at the scene. The two males then fled the area in a light-colored vehicle. A few weeks later, on August 27, 2013, at around 4 p.m., Trayvon and Antonio, who were from the Rollin' 60s, were standing in front of an apartment complex when a light-colored vehicle crept up the street. Trayvon and Antonio spotted the car and started letting off shots first. The occupants of the light-colored vehicle then fired more than 20 shots in Trayvon and Antonio's direction. They both died at the scene, and a third person was critically injured. On June 3rd, 2014, at around 7:25 p.m., Demetrius, Chris, and Reginald were standing talking to each other on the 1800 block of West 54th Street, which is located in Van Ness Gangsta Brim territory. Demetrius then looked to his right and saw a Black male with a gun aiming towards them. The Black male tried to fire, but the gun jammed on him. Demetrius, Chris, and Reginald took off running. Demetrius then saw a car that looked like it was about to chase them, so he hopped over a fence. While attempting to unjam the gun, the Black male continued to chase Reginald. Reginald then slipped and fell onto the sidewalk. The male finally got his gun unjammed and fired 5 to 6 shots at Reginald. He died from his gunshot wounds. Leroy, from the Rollin' 40s, was ultimately convicted of first-degree murder and sentenced to 50 years to life. On October 2nd, 2006, Maisha borrowed her roommate's rented car and drove to her mom's house. At her mom's house, Maisha saw an acquaintance, Akil, and he asked her if he could borrow the car so he can drive to his girl's house. Akil told Maisha he would only be gone for about 20 minutes. Maisha let Akil borrow the red Chevy a little after 5 p.m., and she never saw her again. Maisha then called the police, but instead of telling them the truth, she said that she had left the car unattended and an unknown person had taken it. About an hour later, Ernest, who was from the Rollin' 40s, was standing near the intersection of Vernon and Western. Ernest proceeded to throw up gang signs to someone across the street. Seconds later, a red Chevy drove up and stopped next to Ernest. A man got out the passenger seat and approached Ernest and let off 5 to 6 shots. The red Chevy then drove off at a fast rate. A patrol car that responded to the shooting engaged in a high-speed chase with the red Chevy, which finally stopped in the middle of the street. Two men then jumped out and took off running. Both men fled down an alley. Police canine search teams were brought in, and they discovered both men hiding in two separate locations. Ernest ultimately died from his gunshot wounds. Akil and Chris, from East Coast Crips, were convicted of first-degree murder. On June 1st, at around 6 p.m., Giovanni, who was from the Rollin' 20 Bloods, was talking to his girlfriend, Eshe, who was affiliated with the Rollin' 40s, outside of his apartment. His apartment was located in BPS territory. They were outside talking when James, who was from the Rollin' 40s, drove up. Giovanni saw James arrive and told Eshe to go talk to her homeboy. Eshe crossed the street and spoke to James through his car window. When James flirted with Eshe and offered to give her a ride home, Eshe told him that Giovanni was her boyfriend. At that point, Giovanni then came across the street and stood next to Eshe. He then leaned into the car and asked James where he was from. While this was happening, Eshe voiced her disapproval, but Giovanni told her to be quiet. James looked confused and hesitated before replying that he was from 40 Crip. Giovanni then said he was from 20 Bloods and produced a gun, He fired into the car numerous times before running away. Esche later found Giovanni's gun in the alley and tossed it in some bushes. James died at the scene from multiple gunshot wounds. Giovanni, from BPS, was ultimately convicted of first-degree murder and sentenced to 50 years to life. On the night of December 12th, at around 11 p.m., Britton, Gerard, Tamika, and Sheree were at a party. The party was located in Fruitown Brim territory. Britton was from the Rolling 40 Crips. When the party ended, the group, along with others from the party, went to a nearby AM-PM gas station. Tamika, Sheree, and Gerard went into the AM-PM while Britton stayed in the car. Tamika and Sheree then got into an altercation with two people associated with the Fruitown Brims. Gerard attempted to break up the fight. Eventually, they all got back in the car and started driving off. As they were driving, they told Britton about the altercation at the AM-PM. When Britton heard what happened, he became angry. He said, "Let's get them niggas." They then headed back to the AM-PM where the altercation took place. By that point, the crowd at the AM-PM had dispersed, but Britton spotted the two cars across the street at a Walgreens. He said, "Hey, there they go over there." Britton pulled out a gun, put it on his lap, and followed the two cars out of the Walgreens parking lot. He sped up until he was alongside one of the cars he was following. He then told Tamika to put her seat all the way back and roll down the window. Britton then fired multiple shots into the car. One of the bullets hit a young girl in the head, and she died instantly. Britton, who was from the Rolling 40 Crips, was convicted on one count of first-degree murder and multiple other offenses. He was sentenced to 212 years to life. I'd like to thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.